Hi guys, welcome to this special edition of
Geek Room After Dark. Billy, I didn't order any pizza. You didn't say pepperoni.
And we're gonna make some
Wiener and I made beautiful music together.
But yeah, that Maudy should actually do some voiceovers for people. That actually, you know, not a bad idea.
So, seeing as this is the Geek Room After Dark, me not wearing pants is in theme with this, right?
I didn't expect you to be wearing pants.
Exactly.
Y'all are wearing pants?
I am. No. But that's because I'm on camera. I don't want to get up like that. What? I can't remember which fucking news program it was where the guy was masturbating on camera by accident.
Yes, by accident. No, that's just hunting in your resignation and style.
I wonder if I can jizz out a fucking 2-week fucking notice.
Yeah, like you fucking do a seagull. Here's to HR. Whee!
A seagull? I just thought of, you know what? Don't even explain it. I just thought about that. Nope.
Drag, yeah.
Nope.
Let me just file this for you away under the category of shit white people do.
Yeah. That's, yep. Yeah, it got sent there immediately.
Yeah.
Right. Thankfully.
That was definitely in white people quarterly.
Yeah. No, thankfully for me, it's shit white English people do to each other. So I don't have to worry about that shit.
Seagull.
Yeah. He's not English trash. He's just Irish trash.
That's redundant.
Yeah, fair.
What, Irish trash or English trash?
Yes.
You know what? That's a good question.
Do you guys have your version of Cockney? Is there like an Irish version of Cockney?
Kinda, but you know, the last extermination got rid of most of them.
Why are we laughing at that?
Speaking of trash. Are any of the good members of the Geek Room going to show up tonight? Or are we pretty
Hi, nice to see you. I'm here. Yeah, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Okay.
No, Billy, I wouldn't be saying that if I were you.
Okay. so Luigi definitely got a link to the stream, and we're going to be playing a video from him mocking drag because...
Wait, so the whole video is about me?
I don't know. I have never... It sounds like your wife has watched it more times than I have.
I think she... Wait. She only watched it one time, according to her.
Yeah, so more than I have.
Okay, she says it's about me and one other person. Two other people. Okay. Two other people. Just play the damn video. Okay.
We're rolling this beautiful bean. Oh, wait.
It's... Yeah, the audio just the technical difficulties, Sample. Folks. Just correct.
We need more beer. We need more beer to fuel this. So
I,
I'm gonna grab them.
I fixed it. It took 4 seconds. Calm your tits.
Yeah, but I need more beer. You cunt. Help me understand why men these days have no shame. Why aren't you embarrassed to be a full-grown man playing with Pokemon cards? Logan Paul.
He's kind of got a point.
Watching anime or playing mindless video games as an adult.
Hey!
Why is that not embarrassing to guys anymore? Why don't you have any shame to act like a beta male?
Greg, would you like to answer any of these?
Okay. If there are people in the chat I've been drinking, sorry. If you're not in the know, this used to be Warning Good People. He's changed his moniker again because why not? And he came into the Dragoon Syndicate Discord and he was emasculated quite soundly by a few of us. And so I'd like to ask him questions as why do you call other people beta males and you've never really done anything with your life? And so this seems to be the response to me asking him certain questions that he could not answer. And as to address the questions, I don't play with Pokemon cards. They were all taken away in seventh grade by my English teacher. So there's that. Watching anime, the anime is it doesn't really have an age range. So it's just it depends on the anime. There's some. No, there's actually some just adult anime, just pure adult.
It's called hentai.
Yeah, primarily hentai, but there's no shame in that at all. But I don't. So I'll fight you on that one, Joe. I will fight you.
Yeah, look, it's just when he gets to the video games thing. The video game one.
Like, are you kidding me? Like, that's there's an entire generation that's marketed to of adults for video games. So I'm not so mindless video games. I don't. Maybe there are other video games that aren't mindless. I don't know. I like the mindless ones because I'm too busy doing shit with my life. Unlike the guy who doesn't have a life nor a girlfriend and is probably a rapist.
And probably lives with his mom and talking shit about us not doing stuff.
Yeah.
That should naturally bring about feelings of shame and embarrassment in you. But for some reason, it doesn't. So whether it's Batman 6'4 giggling like a schoolboy...
I never get this whole fucking idea. That should make you feel ashamed and emasculated and all that. Why? Why the fuck should I be ashamed? I like anime. I like games. I like fucking arms. Why should I be ashamed for enjoying the shit I love? It's not like I'm fucking running around, you know, exposing myself to children. That's something you should be ashamed about.
Well, I mean, when it comes to shame, I'm curious if this guy has learned how to hold a fork yet. Look, if we're going to be doing anything about warning good people, can we spend at least a minute and a half on his mukbang? Can we go back to that? Because, I think people should know what we're dealing with, right? Like, if you want to talk about him, fine, but let's show him a little bit. And I think that mukbang is perfect.
If you message me on Discord, the link to that video, I can grab it. But you're not.
I don't know. Somebody has it. I know that. But I think we took it down.
One of those kind of things. Okay. Well, we've got to do this sometime in the future. We got to get this video onto your computer, and we got to because here's the thing. This is not I'm not making fun of a physical handicap, right? He's got all of his fingers, and they work fine. He doesn't know how to hold a fucking fork.
He holds a fork like he holds a baseball. He's not
the kind of person that has to wear a helmet so he doesn't drown in his bowl of soup. But he is the kind of person that doesn't know how to hold a fucking fork.
He holds a fork like you hold a baseball. Yeah. How? Does that even make sense?
No, because I'm trying to
I'm trying to visualize it.
And he's fucking right. He's fucking right.
Yes. You see your nieces or nephews, they're 2 years old, 1 year old, and they're just learning how to use utensils, and they hold it with a fist. That's how this grown man holds his utensils. I've never seen a grown man do that before.
In the movies and shit where the kid is like, I'm writing a letter to Santa, and they're like,
yes. Yes, and they're pressing really hard. Yes, you could hear him scraping the plate
because he has a
fucking claw hammer on that thing.
I want to see him eat spaghetti now. Just trying to see him to spin it. That'd be fucking great.
It was weird too. I don't even remember. It was a year ago, right?
I know toast was on there, and so
it was salad. What? I can guarantee. Like, Billy, what you're saying about the spaghetti, it's not like he sticks the fork in it and then twirls it. He, sticks the fork and drags it around the plate.
It was a piece of dry white bread toast. No butter or anything. That's why it was so wrong. He gets a bite of toast, and I'm like, who does that?
A psychopath. Buys a $40 sword.
Wait, which of the members of the Blues Brothers did that? Was it
that's right. It was a thing.
It's been so long since I've seen
it. It was a thing for one of the but then it was a gimmick, right? He doesn't make anything of it. Like, there's no gimmick. He just
He's just thicker than fucking two short planks nailed together. Got it.
Oh, it's just weird. You gotta see it. We gotta get
see more of this person talking shit about things.
Or whether it's Logan Paul paying $80,000 for Pokemon and wearing little Pokemon shirts and playing with Pokemon cards like a little boy and doing the little
Logan Paul's a cunt, who cares?
Duck face. Why don't men have any shame anymore?
I guess because being shameless is more fun.
They don't have any shame of being rabid sluts.
If I had made this video, I would feel ashamed.
Hold on. It goes from why don't you have any shame? The accurate response is being shameless is more fun. And then it's, they're rabid sluts. Like, okay, someone so far in the closet, he's bumming Mr. Tumnus.
If you didn't catch, he may or may not be an incel.
I mean, I was going to say, that's the first thing he said I agree with. I just...
You pathetic data boys with no self-respect.
No self-respect.
Yeah, I bought the $40 sword. I don't associate
with men like that. Now, you may say, what does it matter? What does it matter what anyone thinks? What does it matter if I don't want to hang out with you? You don't want to hang out with me anyway. Blah, 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 blah. Those are all lies, though. Because deep down, you do want to be.
Hold on. It's all lies. We don't all have to hang out with each other.
What?
You're lying. You definitely want to hang out with this incel. Like,
yeah, I so want racist, to hang out with someone that his entire personality is just saying beta male over and over. Like, you just thought remind me of a certain preacher that deactivated his Twitter.
Oh, that guy. The guy who liked the OnlyFans gay porn?
Yeah, be into what you're into, but, you know, the lady doth protest too much.
Good old JLP.
That's why you hang out with your beta boy friends. So you can't lie. Everyone has that conscience written on their heart, and we share basic desires. So,
okay, that seems like it would be, you know, dangerous, the cardiovascular system, to have that like carved onto your heart.
Yeah, it's not ideal.
Yeah.
Oh, this hey, fucker. Hey, guys, how you doing today? I'm gonna turn that down real quick.
Time has not been good to him.
So,
why do so many people start videos with, hey guys, hold on and I do this thing? Do the thing before you start recording, you fucking weird cunt.
No.
I have to say, I really, I've seen old videos of him recently. I prefer the skullet. I definitely prefer the skullet to the all the way shaved head.
I'm just going to go off on a rant.
Good.
Some of y'all get annoyed by it. So be it. It's nothing about you guys. I love y'all.
He's turning into a fucking cube.
But, like, yesterday, I had my day off, and I got so fucking... I was trying to write. I was really trying to work on my writing, and I couldn't get it done because I just was feeling this overwhelming depression for no reason whatsoever.
Yeah, it's called depression.
Welcome to being an Irish poet. The cure is whiskey.
I was thinking about the AI and the demiurge and all that.
Okay, hold on. I know what those words mean.
What do they mean, Pam?
So yeah, that okay. Thank you. Like, I'm sorry. As a person who suffers from depression, the demiurge in any way, shape, or form, or any prospective AI that may or may not take over the world, that's not a source of my depression. Right? It's like lack of fucking titty pics in the fucking inbox, but
no, I can care less about that shit. It's the people from elementary school that I never see anymore that I think about for some dumb reason, right? It's shit that doesn't make any sense. Then there's also shit that does make sense, the life shit that you dwell on. But when the weird and abstract shit comes into my mind,
what happened to you in kindergarten? Let's explore this.
No. Like, you know, friends from elementary school and stuff. You just like, whatever happened to Lawrence? You know, and that kind of thing. When my depression takes me to the abstract, it takes me to that. Not what.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he probably died of a meth.
What's going to happen to humanity when robots are doing all of our jobs?
Just look at Amazon.
Yeah, I don't think it seems like a bad thing, personally.
Something I call the criminal conscience, criminal consciousness. Because if you, in my view, in my purvey, in my understanding of how I read about the demiurge, the Abrahamic deity, it's the original criminal. It's the original criminal. And I look at our society today and I see how it's been overrun with criminal consciousness. What do I see as what's criminal consciousness in my view? Of course, it's funny because, okay, it's going to work now. Okay. So basically, the criminal consciousness is...
Is that him talking to someone else, like, or just the voices in his head?
I think there's like 9 traits.
Phil, I think it's Alexa. Is Alexa's fucking with him?
He has a few different... I don't know how you describe it. So there's a few different personalities that come out, and then he'll get fixated on something. I'm not a quirky historian, but I can tell that he gets fixated. So his new fixation, or most recent one last year or so, has been the criminally minded person. Irony, he is a felon. So he has to talk about this. And a lot of the feedback that you're getting from this guy doing this analysis is reflected in his own behavior. That sometimes he'll acknowledge that there's a one-to-one ratio there. But other times, there's just absolutely no self-reflection. So when you hear him talk about the criminally minded, just keep in mind, he's probably talking about himself.
But he also is, in another way, he's in no way talking about himself, right? Because, like, criminally minded are also the, like, trolls, haters, they're his versions of Vaughn's everybody that it disagrees with. It's people that disagree with him, right? Anyone that calls him quirky and says he looks retarded, those are criminally minded people. Not that, and that's another reason I think that he uses the term criminally minded, because if he just said criminals, you could go, quirky, you're a criminal. He's gonna go, well, there's a difference. I'm a criminal, but I'm not criminally minded.
For a second, I thought Billy was having a fucking stroke there.
A little bit. I had an itch on my back.
Of criminality. That's fine. Sure. There's there's sadism, Machiavellianism, selfishness, apathy. Just there's all these different traits that basically the criminal has. The criminal, as far as metaphor, see, I need to write a book about this shit because I've got 5 legal pads filled with this stuff.
Oh my god, I would give almost anything for one of those legal pads.
The criminal is like the morbidly obese person who sees somebody taking the last donut in the fucking office.
Like stick figure drawings.
Oh, you know, like the corner of that is just the flipbook stickman fucking shooting himself.
Dude, like that would be the perfect book to start the Tard Book Club with.
It's like the number 23 repeated about 6,000 times.
When clearly the answer to life is 42.
You know full well that a couple of those pages are stuck together because he got a little bit too excited one evening.
I want to know who in the chat would fuck Corky for 80 grand. Male, female, doesn't matter. Just who would do it? 80 grand.
Mr. Pumpkin, there's something you might not know that... this guy's very low testosterone. He actually talks about it often. So there's a good chance that none of those pages are stuck together for that reason. Maybe because he had some chocolate sauce on his finger.
Why does every dipshit come on here and like fucking show their testosterone levels? Like, what the fuck?
I've genuinely never felt the fucking need to check my testosterone levels.
Well, if you did... If you did and it was low, do you think you'd come and bring it to us?
Fuck like, no.
That there's the real question. Like,
I'm going to my doctor and say, what the fuck can I do to get this up a bit? I'm not going to be like, hey guys, welcome to my new video. I have low T. Like, fucking, we can tell by looking at you. You look like an effeminate ball sack. Look at that chin on that bald head. He looks like a ladyboy scrotum.
Office lounge. And all of a sudden feels like they're going to starve. And maybe even starts to throw a fit. Because the criminal is in a scarcity mindset. The criminal wants everybody to be depressed. The criminal wants to destroy businesses. The criminal wants destruction. The criminal actually hates existence itself. It's not gonna off itself on its own. No.
What the fuck is in that vape?
Okay, so I know people that put, you know, cannabis oil in their vape. I didn't know you could get fucking meth.
Okay, his vape is full of stupid. And I got to get me a hold of some of that.
That sounds like you already have.
And real quick, Itty found, I think it was on Amazon, I'm not sure, Itty found caffeine vape sticks. So tonight I'm vaping caffeine. And she that's fucking amazing.
Please don't.
It hits you so much faster than an espresso.
Please don't do that.
Yeah. No, it's good. It's really good.
When his heart just fucking explodes live on air, I want everyone to know that officially we disavow this, but unofficially for science.
No, we disavow this. No for science. Also, thank you, Buck. Earlier, gave him $2 for this is the JV team tonight. Fuck you, Buck.
No. It wants to destroy existence itself. And yeah, there's levels of criminality, just like there's levels of consciousness. However, and you know, levels of creator consciousness. However, the problem we have is we have a situation where the big criminals at the top are using the little criminals at the bottom to destroy everything. So the average person gets pissed off at the little criminal who doesn't really have much power, but they ignore the big criminal.
Is he describing like
a brilliant breeze fairy picture? No, when I said Ladyboy Ballsack earlier.
Yeah, take it back, you son of a bitch.
No, that's fucking hell. His chins are going in five different directions.
Has everybody grabbed his green caps? Hey, Wilson, what up, baby?
Thank you, Buck, for his name is Corky Polson. I'm assuming that's not true.
In death, he has a name. His name was Corky Polson.
I'm surprised Wilson was sober enough to show up. That's surprising.
You just have to click something, man. He's not that drunk.
It is Halloween, and you know.
I'm surprised you could read my name right.
Fuck you!
Let's be honest. He's heard it. He's not reading it right.
I just see the ball, and I know what the ball means.
Because you got the big criminals in power, people like Pelosi and Biden and all these other shitheads.
There's a few people
who are basically doing everything they can.
Wait. There's a few people that would fuck him for $80K.
Yeah. Well, one of them, is definitely an older lady, and she was like, "Fuck it, you know what? I'm going to ride or die." The other's a trans woman. I think there's one other person too, actually, that I missed. So, you know what? You get it for all walks of life, Corky. There you go, $80K. You just got to raise the money, man. Get you some Poo-Tang or Dang-a-Lang or whatever. I'm not going to presume.
There's quite a. I did see some people with some heavy stipulations in there. Yeah,
there's a lot of passes. Like a lot of passes. Like so many passes there, Corky.
To create more criminality among the masses. So you get the masses at the bottom fighting each other, so nobody's paying attention to the criminals at the top.
Mm.
And it's just like every
time. We're trying
time
to vote one of them out.
Apparently. I do a meditation. Every time, you know, I've got my statues up there. All of them are about justice, all of them are about ethics. And it's like,
what is the Baphomet? Yes.
So I heard him talking about, like, Pelosi and Nick or Joe Biden and shit like that. So he's talking about all the people that he can't vote for because he's a felon.
Yes.
All right.
Why are you judging?
Hey, I support felons being able to vote after they serve their time and pay off whatever fines that they have, as long as the fines aren't fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, like presumably, you know, you serve your time, then there's a period of time where you can't vote right after, and then you can start voting again. That makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
But he does fall into the so fucking crazy, I don't think he should have a vote category.
That's most Trump supporters, though.
Yeah, this is true.
I just, you know, I look at my own life and see how the criminals have done everything they can. And I mean, I'm not sitting there saying everybody in my life is a criminal. I'm not saying that at all. But I've
just
had enough
people
with criminal consciousness come into my life for the specific purpose of screwing me over. And it's just like, I'm not going to say I'm a victim. You know, maybe it was my purpose here, you know, to encounter criminals. Maybe one timeline was, I become,
spy guy.
Wait, did he just contradicted himself, right? I'm not gonna say I'm a victim.
It goes into a whole spiel about how he's victimized by the universe.
Yeah, maybe it's my lot in life to go be a victim. I mean, speaking of a lot in life to be a victim, this is a lot in life. She is a whole lot of fucking shanty.
Well, it's a whole lot of not a lot of life left.
Yes, I'm
true.
Pound for pound, she has lived the most life.
Whoever put the comparison up between Shanny in the fucking Care Bear costume and fucking John Candy from Spaceballs, y'all are fucked up.
It's accurate, though.
That's She's her own best friend.
Funny. Well, it's a good thing she is, because no one else is.
Oh, poor Rev.
You guys are my wife.
Also, doing green screens isn't that hard. It's pretty easy. Like, how are you fucking it up that bad?
Billy, look, you say, think about it. The green screen has to have some surface area behind you. If you take up all surface area, how's it going to do its job?
Fair, but green screens are generally ineffective if you make a lot of movements.
Yeah, also not a problem she has.
Yeah.
Speaking of making a lot of movements, you know she ain't doing that. So what, did they just lay a green screen over the back of her bed? Like, is there a green screen over her head?
The last time that she was being hosed off, they got a green tarp instead of a blue one.
But it's just over her bed frame, right? Like, or it's just over her headboard, right?
I don't know.
Like, as
she cleaned herself with a rag on a stick.
What really helped happen is she got one of the chairs, like I have, like these, the gamer chair. You can't really see it, because like they have like a huge, like they have a weight limit. So like I can't wait till the Rev and Shanny games on Twitch, and you just hear it like shatter.
Shanny would need a fucking gaming beanbag chair.
Yeah, she'd hear beans and think unhealthy, must eat.
By the way, I'm so happy they're on Twitch because of those rules. I'm just gonna hit play.
Hi guys, Shanny for Christ.
Hi Shannon.
I got some bad news, guys. I cannot stream on this channel because of that copyright strike.
Aww. Oh darn.
I apologize that I can't. I wish I could.
Maybe Rev will have to start streaming.
They're not gonna allow me.
Oh.
Really high on these copyright strikes right now. Like I said, I suggest people start taking down their videos before they ruin their channels.
Yeah, you guys gotta get rid of those review videos. You're gonna get cracked down on.
Yeah.
That channel app. Who knows? Probably will go to Twitch, guys.
Twitch also has a huge thing with copyright music and shit too.
Yeah. They just fucking nuked years of VODs because of copyright.
Welcome to harassment. They think it's funny.
It's not harassment of people saying, stop using our music, you fat bitch. Continues to I don't know what this is. God damn it, Frank. Okay, let's see. Is it doing anything there? Nope, that's music.
That's more music. More music.
Billy's trying to get the Geek Room canceled.
Looks like I am.
Holy shit. Was this a good idea?
Okay. It's small segments and it's just the stream starting soon. Is it going to end with her fucking cardiac arresting on the carpet?
I hope so.
What was the point of that, Frank? I'm glad your power was out.
Kill
it. I was a bad girl.
Oh,
you're still a fucking horrible piece of shit. Like,
is she talking until up to like 5 minutes ago?
Wait, what?
Yeah.
People doing bad things.
So what you drinking there, Billy? It doesn't look like a Baja Blast.
Oh, it is a Bang Energy Drink Rainbow Unicorn flavor.
Bang!
Could they put more gay shit in the drink for you, man?
I hope so.
Now with extra semen.
Yeah, it was scraped off the brewery floor after the big gangbang. So, yeah, you know, hence the name.
I'm glad. It's just delicious. And there's also protein and shit in it. Electrolytes.
There is.
Very salty.
Uh-huh.
Were you drinking unicorn semen on the rocks?
Why does my soda taste like, smell like bleach and iodine?
Considering there is actually an energy drink called Bear's Thing, I wouldn't be surprised.
She was doing that stupid long waiting thing. Okay, whatever.
We're doing a long waiting thing now.
And it made so many people mad. And, you know, I don't blame people for feeling that way, but I really wish they would forgive me at the same time.
Nah, but
how about an actual apology?
Right, like you can't be forgiven for something you downplay constantly or then outright deny. So I'm not sure what you expect people to do other than just be like Rev and go, well, you know, it's not really that big of a deal, but you know, I'll make you an apology for you and then just accept it. Like that's the easiest thing. We'll just
There's actually an apology video out. Folks, if you don't know, there's an apology video of her out there saying sorry, not sorry. Like it's a joke, right? It's a meme, but like she actually said it. Just saying.
Yeah, she had an apology video, or she apologized to us for sorry your feelings are hurt when we laughed at your dead friend.
You guys are mean.
Did the unicorn eat asparagus or pineapple? Pineapple. Thank you, Buck, for asking.
So just so you know, Buck, maybe sulfur or something in the asparagus that actually gets excreted, and that's what makes your piss smell funny after you eat asparagus. So you might want to go with pineapple because that will actually take some of the tartness out of your seminal fluid. Fun fact.
Drag has done this testing.
Run experiments.
Very, very well, yeah.
You can sell me. Probably too much, but at this point I really don't give two shits because I'm mad as fucking hell. I'm not the Punisher.
What?
I'm mad as hell and I'm not gonna take it anymore.
Happy Halloween, Mo, and Billy still likes sausage. Thank you.
For those who didn't catch the fucking live stream that Vaughn did by himself, Vaughn let a lot of shit slip that he really shouldn't have.
The recent live stream?
Yeah. The one that
it might be in here because it says Vaughn Helen claims he never claimed to be the Punisher 2. So we'll see it's in here. If it's in here, this might be a mashup. I'm just waiting for the super chat to play through my fucking skull. Anytime, StreamYards, come on. Fuck it.
Fuck you. I've been the Punisher. I was a Punisher before Punisher was ever famous. Before anybody even knew who the fuck the Punisher was. I was the Punisher. I've been beat up, I've been stabbed, I've been shot at, I've been fucking hung on a hook and left to die.
In the Cold War.
Dumbasses, what the fuck are you doing? Have you been out in the street?
Wild saying that he's been the Punisher, right?
See, yeah. It's widely believed that all these stories of him being, like, hung on a meat hook and, like, boiled in oil, these are stories that he has reinvented from, like, school days of him being bullied. So, like, the being boiled in oil, that was him getting a swirly. Him, you know, being hung on a meat hook and left to die, that somebody hung him by the fucking flagpole by his underwear. Because you can't bully the Punisher. You don't bully Frank Castle. It doesn't happen.
Well, of course not. When he's as toothless as Von Halten, I mean, you know he's going to fight back. It just won't do much.
And I also believe this was shortly after he got his teeth yanked, so that's why he sounds weirder than usual because he's learning how to talk.
On your goddamn computer. You don't even have the fucking guts to cam the fuck up and face me face to face.
You spent six months in the army.
You don't fucking know me.
Off.
Busting up fucking drug lords and shit.
Yeah.
Arizona, Florida,
Maine. I know.
North Carolina, Pennsylvania, North Dakota. I've been all over this fucking country. My parents don't even know half the shit I've done.
Because it doesn't exist.
You know, I told my parents, I said, I'm looking for a good woman, which was the truth. But in the process of looking for a good woman, I also did my part, too. Because those bitches took my children's lives, and they need to fucking pay.
Wait, is he talking about the women he was trying to get? Like, those bitches took his kids' lives? Or...
I think it was CPS.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Kentucky CPS. They did their job for once.
No, he got it back.
No, they didn't. He got it back.
For fuck's sake.
Actually, they did. CPS are doing great. They did their job 11 times.
Yeah, they're doing their job. The court system is what's fucking up.
And here's to number 12.
It's right around the corner.
It always is.
Don't worry, Vaughn. The 13th one's free. You almost there for your punch card. Fuck.
Lucky 13. That's my number.
13. Vaughn was 11 when the Punisher had his first appearance. Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. He was an early bloomer.
Sorry. Can someone do a quick like punch card of Kentucky CPS violations and like?
Yeah, you know, no, I don't think people are aware. This is important. Like when he gets his kids taken away the 15th time, he actually gets a free coffee from the stand in front of the courthouse.
No, I really want it to like someone to do up a Photoshop one of those things, and it's a fucking raw, like no milk droll of Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Like
no,
just
it's supposed to be Captain Crunch.
Captain, I don't fucking know your shitty American cereals. I have the better stuff.
Captain Crunch is the one that cuts your fucking top of your mouth.
He said he'll do it. He said he can eat whatever he wants, including steak. So I want to see it.
I want to see the steak thing, like a rare fucking steak of him numbing the fuck out of that thing. Like, you get no utensils, bitch. Here you go. Good luck.
No, even better.
He's got to be well done. He's got to really tear at that fucker.
No, I want to see blood all over his face like he is a fucking vampire. Fuck off.
No, I want to see him eat a blue steak.
Exactly.
Like, just seeing that moment where you can't tell, is that gum or is that steak?
I still think the bowl full of lettuce would be funny, too.
Oh, McDonald's lettuce? That would be a great time.
Right. Frank Castle is a work of fiction. I'm not.
Yes, you are.
You need to get that through your fucking head, dumbasses. Anyway, you know, I've faced down my enemies. You know, my killer come right into my fucking house, and I'm sitting there talking to a man who was coming to kill me. And I'm sitting there dialoguing with him. My parents is in there packing shit, and I'm sitting there dialoguing with a man who come to my house to kill me.
Vaughn, we've seen Vaughn try to have conversations. I'd want to shoot you too.
I've been beat up. I've been
Minecraft.
Beat up. Because I went after some of these drug lords. And because I went after the pimps. And I went after the scum of this fucking earth.
Wait, he tried to turn a gun on himself? In Minecraft?
That's just rude.
He is the fucking scum of the earth.
12 times CPS gives him custody of a nuke.
What?
Fuck you, Buck. It says 12 times CBS gives him custody of a new kid.
That is fucking brilliant. The way your system works, probably
true.
That was
so fucking good. Ah, fuck.
You don't fucking know me. My parents don't even know half the shit I've done. Of course, they probably will now.
Especially the horses.
But, irregardless. You know, I'm in Killeen, Texas, fighting against the pimps. I saved 5 women from prostitution. I put my ass on the line. I got shot at, motherfucker.
Okay, hold on.
That's how I saved them from prostitution.
Wait a minute. I think I know how he saved 5 women from prostitution.
I couldn't save her.
Ow.
I saw her take off.
He tried showing up to 5 prostitutes and offering them money for sex, and they all decided to turn their lives around.
I hate you because that sounds accurate, yeah. Ugh, fuck.
And that was the last I ever saw her. So all you assholes get on there, hey, he's just fake, and his guns is fake. He's a fake. He's a... Fuck you.
Oh.
Get your skinny little ass out there, and you try to make a difference. Because I have. And yeah, I asked too many questions. And because of that, my two boys are dead. I know that now. I didn't know it then. Didn't realize it then. Got frustrated, got mad, got pissed off. But I didn't know who to get pissed off at, because at the time I didn't know about this New World Order thing. I knew about the Knights Templar and how crooked they were. I knew about the Masons and how crooked they were. I knew how crooked Eastern Star was. But I didn't quite put the whole thing together at the time, you know?
And then I knew about the New World Order, but I didn't know about the New World Order because I'm dumb as fuck and have no teeth.
What the fuck just happened?
Jesus, that is the fucking screen cap from hell. That's yeah, like give people a moment. Get them screen caps.
I see him with, if you raise his eyebrows up at a point and then made his nose even more pointy and made his skin all green, sort of a goblin thing.
I'm not saying that someone should do, you know, what you see, what she sees.
You can see why those girls are no longer prostitutes.
That might be Von Zoface.
So gross.
Praying Satanist.
Daniel Worldson, where you been? I missed the hell out of you.
What?
For all the scumbags, losers, killers, and haters of this world. Evil must be punished.
Fucking dork.
Now, thankfully, that was not the video, that was not the intro he filmed where Andrea's holding the camera and he's pointing a loaded gun at her.
Okay, let me
is that just like a bunch of names from...
obvious, but aliens, no, that's not obvious. That's complete speculation. You have not seen out of your own mouth. You have not seen an alien with your own fucking eyes.
You have not seen out of your own mouth.
Yeah. He messed up a little bit, but he's got a point. He knows that Vaughn himself said it himself that he hasn't even actually seen an alien.
He shot at one, though.
Also, what platform is this?
That's Stick'Em. I remember Dr. J. He's also missing a couple of tufas, but nice guy. I mean, a little bit of mental illness and meth never hurt anybody, and this guy's a perfect example of that.
That's factually inaccurate.
Yeah.
You thought it might be one, but you're not sure. You don't know what UFOs you see, because that might be, as far as I'm concerned, all UFOs you're seeing, they're fucking American, Russian, they're world technology that we have on this planet that they don't tell us about. But there's no proof of aliens, none, zero, you got zero. So how do you jump from having no proof of aliens, how do you jump from that to jump to a conclusion that Obama is going to rip off his skin and he's a reptile? Don't you believe that they're all reptilians running our government? Isn't that what you believe, Von Hilton?
Dr. J, I just heard the little blink of a tracking device on your end. What the fuck you doing working a tracking device, dude? I know what I heard. I know that sound. That was the little blink of a tracking device, man. That's a very unique sound. What are you doing with a tracking device, Dr. J? What the fuck? What are you fuck you doing over there, dude? Are you a fucking mole? I know what I heard, so don't sit there and say, oh, it ain't. I didn't hear it. I know what I fucking heard, God. Dude. Are you a fucking mole? What was that fucking sound, motherfucker? I know what it was. I heard that little blink. I know what the fuck that sound is. It sounds like a goddamn tracking device. What the fuck you doing over there, motherfucker? Are you a goddamn mole? I heard that little blink. I bet everybody in the fucking room heard it.
You're a completely paranoid fucking nut job. I live in Florida with my wife and three kids, and I work in real estate. I got nothing to do. I expose the New World Order. I'm not part of it. I'm not no fucking mole. You're a paranoid, schizophrenic, fucking nut job, bro. You're a complete case. You need to be in a straitjacket, bro.
Straitjacket my fucking ass. Facts. How many people heard that?
Facts. These guys speaking truth.
Yeah, when someone else is pointing out the New World Order and calling you a crazy person, that it's not a good sign.
Yeah, that's when you start need to reevaluating your own brand of crazy.
This toothless meth head has called me crazy. Oh, that's not good.
Blink when he was fucking talking. How many heard it? Because I know I ain't the only motherfucker heard it in this goddamn room. I know I ain't.
Yeah, look at my nice fucking NWO supporter table here. I smoke my Black & Mild, smoke my bowl with pot in it, fucking drink my Miller High Lives, and then I fucking got tracking devices on Von Hilton. Man, you're a fucking paranoid nut.
That is solid evidence of him not doing that.
Paranoid, go right the fuck ahead, but I know what the fuck I heard.
It's in his tooth.
It might be his.
That's right. See that, motherfucker? That's the fucking tracking device right there, Von Hilton. I'm coming for you, buddy. I'm coming for you. Rawr.
Fucking blind. Shoot you out of the goddamn sky. Try flying your fucking black helicopter over my house again, motherfuckers. Because I'll shoot it out of the goddamn.
What the
fuck? Let's take another example. Okay, they're out there saying that I claim to be the Punisher. No. That's not what I said at all. That's not what I said at all. They chopped up the fucking video.
I don't know who this is now.
I believe that's Jay Stevio. This is the guy that ruined Von Hilton's computer business.
Oh my god, Frank, where'd you get that from? Okay, you can't just be in the background saying things. Give me a second here. I'll shoot. Stop sharing screen. Share screen. Screen two. Boop. I don't know if you guys can see it, but it is Von Hilton somewhere. I'm guessing that's G-Man's live stream. Geek Room is live and trying to get people to call CPS and take my kids again. Okay, so Von, I guess you're watching. We're not doing that. We were mocking you for the amount of times that you have your kids taken away from you and that there's a punch card system. Do we think that's actually a thing? Fuck no. Should it be a thing? Also no.
Let me check my Skype. He's probably crying.
Vaughn, let me just, like, heart to heart, buddy. You don't deserve to have kids. Kentucky CPS needs to do their fucking job.
They do their job. Kentucky fucking court system needs to fucking reevaluate their bullshit.
Yeah, well, someone needs to do their fucking job somewhere.
Vaughn, if you need a large black man's shoulders to cry on, is probably
no.
Come on, drag. It's Halloween. I don't
want this on me. No,
it's New Year's birthday.
He's an overweight coward.
That's true, but no.
I'm curious if we're gonna hear Vaughn talk about how he was the inspiration for James Bond now that Connery's gone.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Please say that if he does that, he tries to do that fucking Sean Connery accent.
It's hard to pronounce her S's like Connery without teeth.
Ooh, let me do mine. Let me do mine real quick. Always with an open hand, never with a closed fist.
A firm open hand slap across the face.
I'd never beat a woman, but I would occasionally, you know, just give her a corrective slap, you know. It's hard to argue with women, but sometimes, you know, never
that's actually really
fist,
good.
Open hand.
That's actually really good.
Soundboard.
Yeah, I'm humbled.
Because if you go back and listen to the original video, the original unedited video.
But your video, your little banner there says James Paul Von Hilton, the Punisher.
I know that, and that's...
Wait, he's denying that he's ever said it, and then Brett Keane, of all people, points out that you literally have it underneath you as a title. Oh my god, when Brett Keane is the guy to call you out. Oh my
you done god. Fucked up.
Jeez, okay. And I just noticed, the second he said it, I was like, oh shit, he's right. So now Vaughn has to go, well, okay, it is my title, but... Oh my god, just let's see the lie.
Let's see a lot. Yeah, see, there you go. That's cold parody.
Yes.
That's a parody. That's called owning that shit and turning it around and saying, guess what? I'm laughing at you.
Yes. Well, the thing of it is, here's the thing. I never actually claimed that. What I claimed in the original video is to be a real-life interpretation of that fictitious character. I've never claimed to actually... In fact, I even said in one video that Frank Castle is a work of fiction. I already know he's a work of fiction. Blah, blah, blah. I mean, I bent over fucking backwards to explain why I say what I say. But see, they cut that part out of the fucking hate video. And so when they post their little hate video, Von Helton is a Punisher. Von Helton is a vampire. Von Helton is a terrorist. Von Helton is... Vigilant. Calm down, six in the morning.
Yeah, and again, this brings us straight back to what I can see quite clearly as being the sport of baiting Von Helton.
Right.
Because all it would take, even though we've been chatting for the last couple of hours, I'm sure if I was to do a video chopping up your stuff in the spirit of fun, yeah, you would possibly have a similar reaction to it if it were not for the fact that we've discussed it and you know that I...
Who the fuck is this?
That's Brian J. He is old school Great Debate Community.
Yeah, he hasn't been around for a minute and a half.
Oh, yeah, then it's not the person I thought it was. He sounds very similar to Jay Stevio.
Is this dude a fucking nutter?
No. He's just really good at tart whispering. Like, incredibly good.
I'm putting it up as a lampoon parody.
Legions! A fucking Muslim terrorists want me dead. But yet not one of them has shown up on my door. Why is that? Why do you think that is, man? Huh? You think it could be because they got word that Von Helton really was the fucking Punisher and that he really did kick the shit out of a lot of gangbangers and a lot of terrorist groups?
No, that could not.
Let's take another example. Okay, they're out there saying that I claim to be the Punisher. No. That's not what I said.
That's not what he just said.
Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Does that make any fucking sense to you? Does it make any sense to you at all? Huh? They'll let a Somali terrorist into their fucking country, but they won't let the Punisher in to stop the terrorist. Isn't that something? Fucking crazy.
Yes, you are.
Fucking crazy. So apparently Canada loves Somali terrorists, but doesn't love the people that try to stop the terrorists. And apparently that is Canada's official policy. Until I hear from Canada's government, that must be Canada's official policy. We'll let Somali terrorists into our country with AK-47s, RPGs, and mortars. But if the Punisher wants to come into Canada unarmed, we can't let him in. Because he might...
Okay, so... Canada has like a really, 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 really strict restrictions on who the fuck they let in their countries or in their country. Like my older brother can't go to Canada because they have a DUI.
So do you know why Von Helton really can't enter Canada?
I do.
Priors.
So it's actually a really interesting story. You want to tell it, Wilson?
Sure. So way back when, and I guess like the, like late 90s, early 2000s, because I believe Von was in his 30s, he met a girl on a vampire forum that apparently agreed to, like, you know, move down to Canada and, you know, marry him. Turns out this, you know, vampire, I believe, was 16 years old. So she tried to illegally cross, like, she may or may not have actually made it to Kentucky. Her parents came down from fucking Canada to get her. And Von almost went to fucking prison.
Did her dad beat the fuck out of him?
I don't know. It's kind of... I don't know the exact details.
If you want the perfect breakdown of Von Helton lore, try and get to the Encyclopedia Dramatica article on him.
I've already read it.
It is very fucking thorough.
It is terrifying.
You're laughing now, but when he fucking gets that 20-year-old Vietnamese, you know, diplomat... We're all fucked.
Well, he's never had an Asian before, even though he practiced karate.
There's a really fun video out there. We reference it every now and then. Nadia's room, the debate coliseum, where Ermin and Mark Anoya were going over the ED page with Vaughn. You know, Vaughn's like, it starts off with Vaughn saying, like, you know, it's a troll site. It's all haters. They'll just say horrible things about you. And they start reading it to him. They're like, so you drew the original design for the stealth bomber. Yeah, well, that's true. You're a ninja. Yes, I'm a ninja. They're going through all the things that all the bullshit claims he makes. And he's like, well, yeah, that's fact. But the site's full of hate.
It's the way they put it. It wasn't nice.
Harm our precious terrorists that we want to cultivate. Yeah. You think I'm kidding, right? You think I'm joking? What do you think the first thing out of that lady cop's mouth was? Well, you look like the Punisher. Do you have guns? That was the first thing out of her mouth. She knew who I was.
You look nothing exactly like the Punisher. The Punisher is over 6 feet tall, has black hair, can grow a beard, and is not a 5'3" fucking hobbit living in the hills of Kentucky.
Is he really 5'3", or are you exaggerating?
He claims he's 5'7", but right, he's also
claimed 5'11".
And he's also claimed he's
different claims. I think about 5'3", 5'4", was some of the original claims.
He claimed he was the exact size as a Wolverine, and that's where he's gonna go.
And in the comics, Wolverine was 5'2".
Ooh. Yeah, this guy's a pipsqueak. Either way, like, he's a small man with small man's complex.
You don't get kicked out of the army in 9 months if you're a fucking not a pipsqueak, I guess, you know.
If you're tall.
Now, there is a video of him doing karaoke next to his bookshelf, and either he's 5'3" or that bookshelf is 9 feet tall.
The idea of Toothless McGee doing karaoke, I don't know why that fucking amuses me so much.
Oh, you've never heard his karaoke?
It's bad.
Thankfully not.
It's worse than Cobes.
The fuck I was.
No.
She knew exactly who the fuck I was.
People eater, man.
You can't miss a big fucking white skull on my chest.
It was great.
You know? Oh, you gotta have guns. No, actually, I use the terrorist guns. I don't need to use my guns.
I love this fact that he's trying to claim that he tried to cross the Canadian border with the fucking Punisher skull on his chest.
Of course she knew who I was. Fuck yes, she knew. Do I look like the Punisher? I more than look like the Punisher.
Insinuating that he is the Punisher.
The Somali terrorists.
He's been lying so much lately, saying I never said that. We just gotta drill it into y'all's heads. It happened. He said it lots of times.
No. Hold on. What he means to say is, I more than look like the Punisher. I look like the Punisher after 50 years of a bad meth habit.
Yeah. There's a great older video where Vaughn's talking about how he was in a scenario where he was getting like beat up in an alleyway by like four people. And then out of nowhere, this young girl's like, hey, Punisher, catch. And she tosses him like a fucking a gunny sack full of his fucking guns, like Mean Joe Green throwing the fucking jersey.
Really?
Here, Punisher, here's your guns. You're going to need them.
Hey, Mr. Punisher, I brought your guns.
Like, it's better than the fucking Poltergeist story.
It's okay. For those same police officers there at the border, Canadian border, to allow Somali terrorists to walk right on by. But if you're the Punisher, you get detained. You get stopped. Oh, well, we need to see your guns. Why ain't packing any guns? Well, we just need to see them anyway. And they x-rayed all my baggage. They x-rayed everything. They even x-rayed me, for fuck's sake. No guns. Okay, and I'm sitting here watching ex-convicts, I'm sitting here watching people with prison tats all up and down their arms, they're walking right on by, I'm seeing Somali terrorists walking right on by, I'm seeing Muslim terrorists walking right on by.
Hold on. You're
I'm
saying seeing the Punisher fucking slept on the job and didn't fucking leap that counter, take the cop's fucking, like, what was it, his fucking
Bream gun and start mowing people down with a Bart 50 cal, because that's what the Canadian Border Police obviously have.
See, I'm thinking of it.
Browning 50 cal, like, yeah, like, we know what you would have done there, Punisher. We can see your evil. We can see the intent to rid the world of evil, you fucking cunt.
I'm thinking of that scene from Airplane where, like, people are just walking through the fucking metal detectors with, like, machine guns and fucking pipe bombs, and the little old lady goes through and it goes off, and they just tackle her.
Yeah, it's like a fucking... You think you can bring a fucking pair of toenail clippers through here? Nah, bitch.
That would be dangerous.
Funny fact, though, there is a very, very odd correlation between this video and present day. Once again, Vaughn has no guns.
that look like fucking Nazi skinheads. They're walking right on by. Nobody gets stopped but the Punisher. Gee, I wonder why that is.
He never said he was the Punisher, by the way.
I wonder why that is. We got to cultivate our diversity by having Nazi skinheads, Muslim terrorists, Somali terrorists, and fucking ex-cons that want to kill and rape and pillage.
What's that, Jack?
I was just saying, don't judge a book by its cover, Vaughn. That's very racist. It's because they're white and they're bald and they look racist doesn't always mean they fuck their sisters.
Exactly. Thank you, Jack.
I mean, if he had to, Vaughn would give a pass to the Nazis.
Oh, yeah, he would.
If he had to, you mean, like, you know, if nobody was looking, they could just, you know, go on.
You keep it within the family, okay?
Yeah. You get out
but
of here.
But if we want the Punisher, no. Can't have him in Canada. No, can't have him in Canada. He might be a dangerous influence, goddammit. Right, Canada? Isn't that right, Canada? He might be a dangerous influence
to our people.
He definitely
never said he was a Punisher, ever.
So we can't let him in the border. God damn it. Fucking hilarious. I'm sitting here watching him go by. I'm sitting here watching him go by. Ex-cons, terrorists of every flavor you can think of, people with criminal records, man, because you can see the prison. To stop them, I'm the bad guy. That is almost a direct quote from Canada, from the Canadian Border Authority. That is almost
for
a direct
I thought
quote.
It was the country of Canada became sapient and said, Vaughn Helton, you are bad.
We're trying to kick him out of our country, but there's nowhere to put him.
Like, dear Vaughn Helton, you are not allowed in our country. Sorry about your luck.
I'm glad that I have...
signed blackface.
I'm glad I had an instructor from Kentucky, because I really have a low perspective on people from Kentucky. Like, he's bad. Y'all need to kick him out. But send him to Alabama.
I don't fucking know. Like, fuck. Antarctica?
No, where does Frank live?
South Carolina.
Send him to South Carolina.
Hold on. You have two fucking oceans on either side of your country, and you're trying to figure out which landmass to put him in.
That's not fair. We can send him to the trash fucking island in the middle of the fucking Pacific Ocean.
Well, I mean, that's his natural habitat plus water.
I know.
Yeah, well, so the perfect. Water might be a problem, because, you know, that might clean off some of the lice.
He wouldn't even notice a change for a while. Like, if we just, like, helicoptered his fucking, like, trailer and dropped there, he wouldn't have a clue for days.
Y'all know he's just going to hear Irish's voice, and you're like, I don't know who that Irish one is, but he should be thanking me. You remember that potato famine they had? That's right. I was the one who helped stop it. Vaughn, you wouldn't... Vaughn, were you born during that? I did. I did it.
I fist fucked the fucking Queen of England at the time, and I saved your crops from that blasted blight. I tell you, I stopped those English and those Somali terrorists that were stealing your potato crops.
Well, you're never gonna hear Vaughn say ill of Vlad Tepes Trakul because he's family.
I fucking hate how, like, Europeans can do, like, a fucking accent of American white trash so easily.
It's not hard.
It's not. But, like, you give an American, like, go do an Irish accent, they turn Jamaican in 15 seconds.
Yeah.
And I disagree with Vaughn being white trash. He's fucking transparent trash.
So for Vaughn, the world is just one big episode of Walker, Texas Ranger. Yes, it is, Buck.
The answer to keeping the Jamaican out of your accent when doing Irish is you keep it short. Keep it less than 15 seconds. Just dee 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 dee. Oh, potatoes. Like, that's it. And that's all
you hear. If you be talking shit about the Irish accent, I tell you what, I'll fucking come over there and I'll beat the fucking shit clean out of you. I tell you what now, boy. I tell you what now, boy. I
have a fucking clue what you just said.
And at the end, do you want to go if that's American, it turns into Bircon.
What is that funny?
That was Pikey. We don't speak of them. We don't acknowledge them. We hope they go away.
Wait, is that your guy?
Is that like the old version of Bookies?
No,
Pikey is like it's like half Irish, half Gypsy.
I don't
know. Pikey's all Gypsy.
White people to me. I don't fucking know this shit.
Okay,
it's like Snatch.
So on the totem pole of whiteness, the Gypsies are below pretty much everyone.
Okay, I understand that. Yeah.
No, okay.
White people. We can be racist against other whites.
Well, funny bit of history revisionism that Vaughn pulled last night. Was everyone aware that the Irish were the first people enslaved in America?
No.
Oh. Kind of fucking dumb.
The Irish were treated so below other whites, yeah, but okay. not that. No.
This is very similar to the big fucking rant I went in about Shani doing her whole fucking, the Irish slaves were bought for after slavery was abolished and fucking slaves were freed. Irish were the right color. Like, yes, there were Irish slaves. No, don't use it to justify your racism, you fucking inbred pieces of shit. I'm also not going to get into the full rant again.
It took a while for the Irish need not apply bullshit to go away. But, like, yeah, you can just move to towns and then not call yourself O'Reilly anymore. Like,
another fun fact. Guess, according to Vaughn, who the majority of slave owners were in America during the time of slavery.
If he says black people, I'm going to kill him.
Jews!
Nope. Billy got it right.
Was it the blacks?
Yep. No. He claims that black people were the majority of slave owners because they were free slaves in the South that were able to somehow purchase land.
Oh, okay. Vaughn, as someone that actually understands a bit of history, and bear in mind, I'm looking from the outside into your fucking cesspool of a country. No.
No, we
fuck
know that.
You.
No. Just
not
simply,
that big of a cesspool.
Vaughn, just in general, no. In every facet of your life, whenever you have a question,
no.
Whatever
you
said
is probably wrong.
This morning? No.
So Vaughn is trying to he's trying to claim reparations on two different fronts because he wants reparations for one being white and two for being 65% Native American.
Is he only 65% now? Because he was 130 at one point in time.
He was 130.
That was when he first tried to do math, and math Vaughn not good.
You fucking were lowballing him. He was 132. You get it right. You take off those 2 points, and you're demeaning him.
No, wait. Hold on. I think I know what it is. I think Vaughn, he was trying to count the chromosomes, and because he has a couple extra, it just kind of sort of slipped in there.
Ah, fuck. Mo asked a question, which... I'm gonna put my money on black. How would Vaughn fare against Tyrone?
Tyrone would bend Vaughn over and fuck him.
Would beat the
I don't think Tyrone could handle the smell.
Would beat the.
He would assume he was getting tear gassed and bail.
Like the reason the Tyrone thing is so funny is because he's so goddamn yoked. Like he's just ridiculously large. So he can go up to a group of people like, I'll fuck your wife and have no fear. So yeah, Tyrone every day of the week.
Hey, just in case Vaughn is still watching. Hi, Stinky.
Who is Stinky?
You are.
Okay, who's Stinky?
Jello, I have to give you credit for that. You were the one that started it, but I was the one that got him to say the words.
I don't know who Stinky is, but I'm leaving. Bye.
Okay, apparently you're gone. 175%.
Okay, I'm good.
No, Lord.
Something to correctly burn or prepare sausages or hot dogs.
It really makes me nervous.
So putting it on the stove may not be a good idea. A better way would be to burn them with a lighter.
Oh my fuck.
What? Oh, this is great.
If Jell likes that, it makes it terrifying.
Okay. Why do you have a fart in the bathroom?
My bathroom the same way, but I know no one in my house.
Think the sausage?
Those aren't sausages. And how is the inside of your fridge the cleanest part of your house?
You gotta be careful when you cut it open that you only cut a little bit, okay? So that you don't, like, destroy the things there.
Well, you could just cut the side of it to clean the dogs.
Okay. So, like, you gotta hold the sausage and use a...
Why is he pulling hot dog sausage?
Why does he do everything that he does in his life?
What is in the blender?
Okay.
What's in there?
Please tell me. Oh, yeah!
Not too much. Then you pull it a little bit, and you use something to hold the sausage.
Some people
in place.
Put mustard on their hot dogs, some people put relish on their hot dogs.
No, you don't want to do that too much. Because at some point, the sausage is going to have, like, weird things that are going to pop up, or, like... You know, there's going to be some weird things, you know, that are going to, like, liquid or something. So, just do a little bit on each side.
Do you not own a microwave?
His trailer smells like roast beef and yogurt.
Now, another strategy is to drill
little holes.
That's where
you keep your cat.
In the sausage. Now, I'm going to teach you how to do it.
Oh,
you got to be very careful.
No, that one's gone.
Like this.
Throw it away.
You know, this allows some... heat to get in, okay?
That's not
it's
why
hit the floor. Please hit the floor. Please hit the floor and try to cook it again.
Wait a minute. Okay, I have this.
Oh
candle.
God, he's gonna use a candle.
It can also be used for sausages.
No.
You have a.
What are we doing?
A little fire, and you can just hold the sausage over it.
Look. Okay, so it's gotta be. Look.
You
he
see?
Went bought a candle for this video, right?
The like, black thing that you see there, it doesn't matter. It's just dirt, okay? Like, you can
it's
clean it away.
It's
sucker at some point.
Hold on. Hold the fuck up.
Just like
I'm Irish.
Like that and...
My country is not known for our culinary talent, and I'm looking at this with utter fucking contempt. Why?
The Mud Broker, $2. Use a Zippo for better flavor. Oh, fuck.
I want to know if Sam likes Savide's hot dogs.
Why?
I want hot dogs in 2 hours.
No, people boil hot dogs already.
According to Sam, they're called peasants.
Fair.
I need another fucking beer.
It's a good way to clean, boil or prepare sausages. It takes
water,
a little clean, though.
Clean, boil.
Another alternative would be...
They're fucking hot dogs!
A sheet of paper.
He just left it!
Or something.
He left it! He left it!
Okay, like a receipt from a store, okay? And you
there's
burn it.
A new candle
and you put it
brand new fucking,
like, under the sausage.
Vase or whatever. Like,
oh, for fuck's sake.
I'm about to strangle this dude. Where is it?
He just found random trash. He's cooking it. He's cooking it under
it
a trash
weird,
fire.
Don't worry. I mean, it's just
a
temporary thing. You can always clean it up a little
girlfriend.
Bit.
If it smells weird, don't worry. It's
well,
all
you're
okay.
Taking notes now, eh? Okay.
He's getting in vanilla.
He put the candle out with the hot dog.
He used the hot dog to put. He has, folks. This dude has no intention of eating that hot dog.
What? He's using soap.
He just rubbed soap on it. He just.
Man, you can eat it like with bread, or like you can cut it in pieces, or
take a bite. Take a bite. Please.
You know, you can also extrapolate it back there, or boiling water. But it's a little tough to boil water because. You gotta take things away.
You have to put things away.
See, I have an image in my head right now of like a year and a half ago with G-Man in the house with his fucking hobo fire cooking a hot dog. Even he would call this guy a fucking idiot.
G-Man grilling chicken.
You put water in there and...
the fucking slap.
Well, okay, wait a minute.
Just
too much water because for some reason it makes weird things.
Why is there duct tape on the fucking pot?
And then you just put it there and...
If he hadn't used a lighter on it, he could have just started off this thing and would have had to wash.
Oh my god, where's the switch at? Here.
And then you just sit there and wait. You can do things with the other sausages as well. For example, you can mix the sausage with the peach juice. Which I made with a little bit of water. This time it works better.
No.
I mean,
I don't know why. Sausages always taste good when you eat peaches at the same time. So why not, like, put them together?
What?
You know, so,
first, my phone.
I hate this. I hate everything about this.
Smells a little bad, but that's just because...
Wait, you can smell anything in that goddamn apartment?
Coming there, I think it's not supposed to be that.
I agree with him, though. There's a lot of things you can do with sausages.
You can use this to... with a drink.
Something's on fire.
Okay, there's fire. There's fire happening. There's fire. Get the salt. Get the salt. Where's Cobra?
Okay, I'm gonna.
He's wrong.
Motherfucker.
That was the wrong one. Okay, I turned the wrong.
We're gonna lose our set.
Number. Wait a minute.
Get the salt.
How does he still alive?
I'm gonna take care of this. Okay.
He's now really good at putting out fires, Jack. That's how.
Boil here,
it's fine, folks. We got
I
it.
I think I turned the wrong handle. You see these little handles? Yeah, yeah, like I turned this one, but the sausage was actually on this one. So I turned the wrong one, and the flashlight.
It happens. It can happen.
You caught the flashlight on fire. How the fuck do you catch a flash?
Well, it doesn't
matter. $2 from one broker.
It's just a flashlight.
It's just a flashlight. Don't worry about it.
Just throw it in that pile.
There goes.
Damn, that's gonna cost a lot of money to repair.
No, it's not.
To repair.
Espresso coffee is. Well, I don't know. I can still use it, I guess.
Oh boy. Who repairs a flashlight?
Okay, so we still have the sausage and peach juice here, which can make a good drink.
Thank you, Mud Broker. And then it got worse. Yeah.
No.
Oh, no. Please drink that. Please drink that.
I don't
please.
Know if I can taste this. I don't know if it's gonna be.
Jesus fuck.
Fuck, what a smell.
I hope this stupid burns. There you go. Oh,
man.
You
idiot. Shouldn't have done that. Okay, guys, don't mix sausages with peaches.
Yeah, thanks, buddy. We didn't know.
I never would have figured that out on my own without this informative video. Thank you,
man.
Billy, for exposing me to this fucking creature.
It wasn't my fault. This is. I'm gonna blame Jello.
I'm going back to my house tomorrow, so this place is gonna be like abandoned for a couple of days now.
Here's a house.
It's a good thing it already looks that way.
Okay, I think I better go to sleep or something.
He has a house?
Whatever. Okay, good night, boys.
Who the fuck keeps a hammer on their toaster?
Hey, guys, Stuart Pidlow. I just wanted to make everyone aware. I told you guys in the past that I can't have, like, aquariums. The last time I used to have aquarium all the time, big, beautiful aquariums, and I couldn't have them because of the, oh my God, that's horrible. Because the directed energy weapons would kill them. My family made this jack-o'-lantern not even a week ago. and look at the rot. Look at the amount of rot in less than a week's time. It's completely dilapidated. There's nothing left of it. It's absolutely destroyed.
What happened to it?
Why do you do this to my people?
Last about 2.5 to...
Wait, what?
Why do you do this to my people? They live their life on the patch, and then you drag them away and carve them up, you bastards.
All right.
Angry Pumpkin. No.
Because your name is what you're doing now, yeah.
Because your name is Pumpkin. I get it.
You guys.
Yeah, this guy's a retard as well, so, you know.
He's also a huge Trump supporter. All right.
3 weeks. Because of the directed energy weapons they hit me and my home with, this is what's left of that jack-o'-lantern.
What?
Less than, I think, five or six days.
Day after it's rot, folks.
And this is all that's left. That's how bad they hit us with directed energy weapons.
What?
The foundation underneath my house has collapsed because of these weapons.
It has nothing to do with the rot at all. Nothing.
My body is the exact same as this right here. It turns it to mush. No cartilage in my joints. My bones are broken down. Muscle mass
increased. I could have sworn I almost heard him giggle. Like,
teeth falling out. All because of directed energy weapons.
My toes have turned to powder.
That are on me all the time.
Okay, I can see that pumpkin photo there. Fuck you.
Be saved.
This is a picture of me from two Halloween.
What's up, everybody? Last year I made a video of eating a 1-year-old egg. It's the same package. It's 2 years and 2 months old.
No.
Okay. Do you guys know who this guy is?
Oh, he eats raw meat all the time.
He eats raw meat, right?
No, he eats high meat and raw meat. So
yeah, that's why I said raw meat.
Yeah, this is his high meat.
Right.
Where he'll eat shit that's like really old and rancid and. It is the worst.
So that's why he's so skinny, is because he's constantly got food poisoning and retching his guts up.
He claims he doesn't. He did do one real funny thing one time. There was like a vegan rally, and he stood in like one of their faces and started eating like a squirrel he just found dead on the road. That was kind of funny. We got arrested for it. And he also did a video 1 year of, like, staring at the sun and said it wasn't that bad. And his next video was like, hey, guys, staring at the sun is really bad for you. Don't do that. It hurt my eyes. So that was a good time.
When he says this is a – so apparently it's a 2-year-old egg.
2-year-old
egg. 2 years and 2 months.
It's just an egg that you would buy from the store that you've had for 2 years. It's not like one of those weird, like
– It's not a century egg.
It's not a century egg. He's just –
Okay, I'm trying to decide which one would be worse, because I've actually tried a century egg, and...
Century eggs actually have some kind of preparation into them. This guy's just a fucking idiot.
Yeah, this guy has it.
I know they have a, like, it's a long prep time, but they're still fucking disgusting.
Oh, yeah, they're horrible. But this is way worse. I don't understand why people eat them, but this is somehow more terrifyingly worse.
Yeah, this guy just, like, it's like comparing, like, when you go to one of those fucking, like, awesome steakhouses that have aged fucking beef versus this guy just had the beef. So let's watch this. This is not going to make us want to throw up at all.
I've got one egg left. It's hard inside.
What the fuck?
I have no idea what to expect.
Me either.
Okay.
If he cracked and a fucking chicken pops up, I'm gonna fucking die.
So will he.
Oh my. Wow, okay.
It's exploded in my mouth.
Oh boy. Okay, so this is what happens when you leave a raw egg for... Wow. Last year, it was completely liquid. It's completely hard inside.
Don't put that in your mouth. Like, don't put that in your mouth. Please
no,
don't put
do
that
it.
In
do it. Do it.
Watch him do it. Stare at it, Billy.
Do it, here pussy.
Wow.
Chew it.
Don't take a bite. But the whole thing.
No, chew it.
It's like jerky.
You gotta chew it.
That's so gross. How is this motherfucker alive?
If you listen closely, you can hear this guy getting salmonella right now.
Yay! Raw egg jerky.
Taste is like
goddamn white people.
Anyway.
Yeah, what the fuck, no, white people?
Y'all saying it, not me.
Y'all are going to make me racist against white people.
Hold on. Wait a minute. From this accent.
Kind of like last year?
He's European as fuck. Yeah, he's like trans.
Yeah, he's not a real white person. Like,
that motherfucker's Swedish.
Yeah, I think he's Swedish.
And it sounds like maybe a little bit of gay in there.
that's just the Swedish.
I don't know if it's just funny.
I got to give the dude credit, though, because in 37 years, that is the first time I've ever seen someone crack an egg on their fucking teeth.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're all kinds of firsts for today, right?
Yeah, for 37, you look easily 45.
I got to say, then I'll give the last guy credit. I've never seen anybody put a raw hot dog in a blender with some peach juice.
Please stop giving out credit to the tards, okay? Don't.
It's all they have left. This is community service.
Aftertaste to it.
It tastes like regret.
Not really bad, though.
Okay, wait. Eat that fucking egg jerky. Or eat one of those cookies that one bitch made.
Who's the one bitch?
The semen cookies.
How old's the semen?
It's a few months, but it's been in the freezer.
I'll take the semen cookies.
I know I have a fucking loud laugh, but Jesus, that's fucking hell.
You really, the semen cook, really? Really? Is that what we're doing?
At least the semen cookies won't fucking murder you. There's a good chance that egg might fucking kill you.
Look at the face on this man. This is a man who's realizing this is the last video I'll ever make.
No, he's never made that face ever now. That's just the face he makes when he does things.
Significant taste overall.
Significant test.
Mm. Pretty nice.
Fucking sweet.
I've not died yet.
Strong egg yolky, cheesy sort of flavor.
Cheesy.
That's a good sign.
Okay, the aftertaste, it was there at the start. I don't taste anymore. Now it just tastes kind of good all of a sudden.
That cheesy flavor, that's the age. That's aged egg.
Now a very strong taste of sulfur.
Does anyone smell toast?
I don't know if it's worth fermenting an egg for 2 years to eat this.
No,
it's not fermenting.
Maybe. Is that really fermenting?
By the way, no, it's not.
That egg was a closed ecosystem. It has not fermented.
Crack, but not really crack, the eggshell. Hit it one against each other so there's no visible crack, but that way air can get in and it ferments better. Quicker and definitely different. I don't think that would ever happen to an egg after 2 years. This is just super weird.
Do I hear children in the background?
That's the dog he's going to eat later.
Reproduce strength.
I mostly do these videos for fun and because people always think that you would get food poisoning from eating old, rotten food, even though, of course, really, it's just a natural process of fermentation. No toxins, poisons come from it. That's why you can't get food poisoning from it.
This is why no one trusts the Swedish.
Years and years of being badass Vikings have led to this.
No, so I'm guessing his gut flora is very diverse. So he's probably pretty used to what would normally make all of us shit ourselves for weeks. That's more than
no. That there's no excuse. As soon as this video ends, he is running into the bathroom and vomiting his fucking guts out.
I'm willing to bet like his mouth biome is like that of a Komodo dragon. Like if he bit you would fucking die.
After eating one of those, fuck yeah.
They're super hard. Like eating bugs almost. I would imagine.
Feel me in progress.
He's a better parent than Shani and Rev. What the fuck?
And Vaughn.
That goes without saying.
I mean, it depends on what he feeds.
Well, I won't say
to be fair, Vaughn is a part-time parent.
Waiting for this. I think the 1 year old in that sense is better. It's still custody
with CPS. Like,
this is.
You're an asshole. I just took a fucking beer. Ah,
oh, that's a fucking like, sin in your country.
If yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Dean. TripleWTheManMindset.com. You know what? I am thinking I might do a hit and run Friday show. And today is Friday. I'm thinking about it.
Don't
not
say
too
hit
sure.
and run when you're behind the wheel.
Is he gonna threaten to fuck somebody's wife, long dick style?
I hope so.
Okay, they don't look remotely alike.
Oh, this isn't that guy.
No, I know they look all alike to you. But yeah. You can't just say that.
Oh, I shouldn't. Okay. I didn't say that.
Inside voice. But,
that's not here nor there. But what I want to talk to you today about is
funky cold Medina.
Attract women.
I wasn't right there.
And
either.
How can you start doing it today? That's what we want to talk about. Now, for a lot of you guys
what the
out
fuck,
there,
Frank?
A lot of you guys feel like the outside world determines how we feel as men. For a lot of you guys, I know it's tough out there. I know you got fears, anxieties, and things that are slowing you down and stopping you from your greatness. And I know sometimes it feels like the world is against you. Yes, you know the world is against you. Women are against you, and sometimes males are against you. There are a lot of elements that are against you. So you have to understand that's just how life is.
Okay,
but
what
a lot
fuck,
of you guys
Buck?
Don't understand is that it's not the.
So this video was sent to us by Buck. Frank has no clue what's in it.
Buck sends shitty video. Skip it.
Yeah.
Okay. Buck, okay. Can you do me a huge favor? Drink less.
Like the prison guy that Buck sends is funnier than this. Oh God!
Jenny for Christ here, and I just want to let you know that I'm over at Twitch right now, and we're doing a horror movie watch-a-thon. We're gonna start watching Children of Corn right now. So come to Rev and Shanny Games at Twitch, and we'll have a good spooky Halloween, watching scary movies and chit-chatting and having a good time. Peace, guys.
Holy fuck!
Hunt mode.
Did she do a makeup tutorial today? Is that what happened?
The paint
no,
can.
I had to pause it because of that fucking goddamn thing glowing on it. Goddamn. Yeah.
Oh, that's her power stone. That's how she channels her magic.
It's like Vision from fucking Infinity War.
Yes.
The fucking forehead wart is still prominent even with all the makeup.
Folks, today I'll be testing the Jeffree Star unicorn threw up on me palette.
I am just waiting. Jeffrey. The best part is I'm waiting for the day that there's one of those makeup tutorials where that fucking thing explodes because I know I will just be fucking inundated with people sending me the pictures of just like,
how many spiders come out of there?
Wait, when you say that thing, do you mean Shanny or that big ugly thing on her forehead?
Well, at this moment, it's not sure which is growing on which.
And one more sandwich, and she's gone.
So okay. You know the old story of like the princess and the pea. When Rev eventually tries to smother her with like 13 pillows, you're gonna see that little fucking lump in the middle of the fucking pillow.
So, just looking at this abomination in front of me, all I can think is that barnacle on her forehead. I'm not sure which is the parasite sucking the power from the other. Like, just when it finally pops, which end? Is it the fucking giant spider-infested mole on her head, or is it just the rest of it? That's please take that off the fucking screen. That's horrifying.
No, I want to leave it up there. It's Halloween.
Yeah,
Woo! That's... Wait, here, I'll make it worse.
I'll make it worse by just making it choppier. Thank you.
Make it spooky and retarded for your Halloween viewing pleasure.
I don't like you.
Why not?
Can we get a side by side?
Who's got side by side of what?
On a fucking dead dog?
No, who made the fucking Spaceballs reference? Who did that?
I don't know, but I can tell you right now, she looks like if fucking David Bowie dressed the good lord.
Is that better?
I guess we're doing this now.
When did Frank shave?
My dog is very confused right now. I just hear that.
Frank shave.
What the fuck is going on?
I wish we would do a definition
of making a video. Okay. Knowing your audience, I can say for sure there's at least a couple fucking erections right now.
Well, thank you for admitting to having an erection.
Well,
see,
you know.
Whoever did this video, it would have been a lot funnier instead of using like the weird Halloween music to do the song Goodbye Horses. If anyone knows the reference.
sure.
I'd check me your messages, Drag.
I'd fuck me hard.
Would you fuck me?
I'd fuck hard.
I'd fuck myself off a cliff rather than going near that thing.
You look like you take a snake.
I can't hear a fucking word you're saying over that creepy shit.
The last thing Frank's wife sees before she goes to bed.
The last thing the hooker sees before she ends up on the myth.
I'm not seeing any messages from Frank. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm sorry, Frank. I love you.
Frank, what the fuck is wrong with you, Frank? Goddamn.
Is he trying to look sexy? Is that what this... Oh,
I
God.
Think that's what's going on. Frank, what are you doing here, dude?
Frank is just fulfilling his fetish right now.
Frank has gone full meta.
Ladies, change the tiles you're sitting on.
Is it gay, Frank, if you beat off to someone that basically looks like you?
Frank, how are you telling me you're doing today?
Oh, I see. Okay. That's a baby.
I mean, it's mean to say that Frank looks like this guy. Because
it's
he
not.
Doesn't,
it's accurate.
He doesn't quite look like... Like, if this guy and Tardeted Citizen loved each other very, very, very much, you would get Frank.
So Frank is the bastard child between fucking Tardeted Citizen and this idiot?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I'm not willing to make the claim, but I think it's worth an investigation.
Who made this? Why?
Who's still playing it?
I'm fine until it goes to the end. I don't fucking care.
I think my dog's trying to fucking kill itself in the corner after it caught a glimpse of this.
Yeah, I think I am too.
This is for science. I'm waiting for Jello to do it. That's why we had him on tonight. That is internet gold of Jello.
Jello's on the power bank right now.
Joe's getting ready to heave right now. This is fucking redunculous. At least show some nipple.
No, he has to. He has to do his sultry
porn too.
He has to do his sultry pose right there. That's what really gets your motor going.
As she's reeling in like the 4 foot titty, like.
Lower the camera to waist level so I can see them nips. Yeah. Sorry, that was Weston and Ron.
All right.
Thank you.
Yep, little red sign, excuse me. Little red sign says, we are live, we are live, we are live, and it is so.
And it is so.
This is going to be my, I think, first ever I was right on Facebook.
Facebook edition, I was
just
right.
The Facebook
Woo!
Edition of I was right.
him sad, folks. Him sad.
Him what? Big sad.
For the ladies, thank you for the fucking super chat, Buck, but yeah, okay. Drink less.
Because I was right, and I'm going to be able to prove it with evidence.
Bring your own bell. All right. Thank you.
I have known all my life, and
by the way, I agree with many others.
There's the 6 a.m. bill, by the way, for those of you that are wondering. I have known all my life, and many other people,
what have you
my
known?
Age and even younger, have known about this.
My age too, Ron.
It's an unwritten law. It's something you don't do.
What don't you do?
You just don't do it. All right. And one of those things you just don't do is fuck with somebody on their birthday.
Oh, that's true. Maybe
if you weren't such a colossal piece of shit, no one would fuck with you on your birthday.
Yeah, and by the way, Vaughn, I did wish you a happy birthday. Well, I gave you birthday wishes. I wished for you to lose a foot and an eye. But those were real birthday wishes. It was sincere and from the heart.
And one of them definitely is going to be coming true pretty soon.
Oh, they're both going to be coming.
The foot one.
I wish a sincere wish that the courts of Kentucky would do their job as well as Kentucky CPS.
We just got this message from O'Reilly. They disavow. Based on his hat. How do you feel about that, there, Pumpkin?
Oh, he's got an O'Reilly hat.
See?
Deedly, 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 dee. O'Reilly.
Now, ever since Bill O'Reilly, we have disavowed that name. It doesn't exist.
Oh, fuck fair. It, we'll do it live.
Now, if you want to keep here talking shite about my accent, I tell you what, I will fucking hit you with a hammer.
Vaughn has claimed to be part Irish because apparently his hair used to be red.
Oh, Vaughn can fuck himself with a cactus. In Minecraft.
Well, that would be in Skyrim. He hasn't figured out how to mod fucking Minecraft yet.
Yeah, the horse vaginas are definitely too cubic for him.
No matter how bad you hate them, no matter what they might have done, you don't fuck with somebody on their birthday. Now, you say, well, Vaughn, where did this thing come from? Where did this unwritten law come from? You know, I honestly haven't Googled it to find out.
Well, but I'd say it's fucking Google it, considering it's unwritten, you dumb motherfucker.
It's also not real.
It's unwritten. As old as the Wild West, maybe even before that. I know in the Wild West that if you tried to mess with a man's horse or his wife or his house or his farm, it was a hanging offense.
Literally. Yeah.
It was literally a hanging offense.
Well, hang you for messing with someone on his birthday.
You know, and likewise, you didn't fuck with somebody on their birthday.
Likewise, because it's a hanging offense. Hanging offense.
Because
hanging.
That was their day.
He's wiping tears.
You know, my theory on it, and admittedly this is a theory, that was the day the gods brought you into this great earth, and
the creator gods.
The gods, you just don't fuck with nobody on their birthday.
That's true. Respect for the gods, if not the person, for the gods.
What if that person's a colossal piece of shit?
See, I think
then it's different.
I think Vaughn does have a sound reason why nobody fucks with him on his birthday. It's because somebody fucking likes you, Vaughn. Like even your mom didn't wish you a fucking happy birthday.
Nobody likes
Vaughn.
To be fair,
she probably forgot. But
what year
happy
is
birthday,
it?
Happy birthday! Happy birthday to me.
Oh god, that was so fucking sad.
I love it.
I wonder if his kids wish him happy birthday because they've been living with a different family for the last year.
No, they were just fucking wishing themselves never to go back to that cunt.
Happy birthday, old daddy.
No, they're like, okay, happy birthday. That's 1 year closer to death.
Folks, it's a banner year. The door isn't barricaded and the kids are home. Actually, I'm just that. Assuming the kids are home.
The kids should be in another home.
But that would be my take on it. You know, that was the day the gods created us, brought us into this world, into this plane of existence, into this computer simulation, according to Elon Musk. Well, that's when the creators brought us here and... you know, so out of respect for the gods, you just don't fuck with somebody on a birthday.
Well, who fucked
okay,
with you
so,
on your birthday,
it should come as no surprise, then.
Who are these colossal pieces of shit? Oh, the Geek Room.
And Black Guy TV.
Black Guy TV, of course.
I think that's why he brought up the hanging offense.
That's gotta be.
We got hit with a privacy complaint. Over what?
Who did?
Apparently we did. What did we get hit? Frank, if you're gonna like say things behind the scenes, come live. Hit the button.
Yeah, Frank, you're one of the good ones of the much
to be the biggest
fuck you
punks in the fucking planet.
Bring Braun, then it's like we actually have a proper fucking geek room experience. Not with
fuck
this piece
you
of shit.
I decided to do several hour long hangout doing nothing but trashing me on my birthday.
On his birthday.
But then we've got this newcomer guy called Black.
We were
guy
laughing!
Peter,
we were having
who
fun!
Decides, I'm gonna do it too. Why should the geek room get all the credit? I'm going to do a several hour hangout trashing an old man in Kentucky that's never done anything to me.
Apparently he missed Grampy Lobster. We did it there too.
Yeah. And granted,
I think Grampy was upset that that fucking Vaughn didn't mention him here on this cry stream.
I'm a little hurt. Sure,
yeah. Because the last time Vaughn went off on one of these rants, he went from secular opinion to Grampy Lobster. And that was like a high point for Grampy.
Yeah, yeah.
What's up, bitch? You got your power?
Yeah, I got my power.
So, how are you doing?
I'm good.
So, what did we get a privacy complaint for?
All right, so it was on the one of the salt mines. It was, where'd it go? With the Xbox controller. It was a while ago, actually. It was legit. I think it was at the point where we were showing somebody a circuit court judge or something like that, but we got hit with a privacy complaint. So I figured, you know, since you wanted me to come on and explain it. But yeah, they're just giving me a chance to edit it, so I'm just editing it out.
All right. How's Halloween going for you and your family and the used kid?
Oh, we are not doing anything.
So when you have kids and there's COVID, you do dumb shit like you get packaged candy and hide them around your domicile and have the kid go play hide and seek with the candy you hid.
It's like Halloween and Easter.
Halloween Easter bunny.
Did you could have done that, Frank.
Did you put on a fat suit a suit to hide the candy?
Say fat suit. I'm not. I don't need a fat suit.
No, I meant drag.
Oh,
yeah. He doesn't need one either. That was the joke.
Well, I did. I put it on the Snorlax outfit the other day, and I put the fucking pillow inside of it. And
you dressed up like Johnny?
Those buttons were hanging on for dear life.
I was surprised that was a costume.
That was a costume. Part of it was a costume. Most of it was me. Most of that was me, baby.
No, that was fun. Somehow I like you better in costumes than I do Shanny and Rev. Just saying. I think it's fun. It's not fun when they do it. It's annoying when they do it. Remember when
fucking just complimenting film was like, I like you better than bubonic plague.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, they did a horrible one. She was like a pink teddy bear and he was Ken from Street Fighter. And I had to put my head through the wall 3 times. It was terrible.
Shanny would have reminded us that Grampy is 200 subs away from 1,000, and he would just fall over and pretend to be dead if he got to 1,000.
Again.
He might not be pretending this time. Folks, sub to Grampy Lobster, please, if you haven't already, please do so. And also, you know, make a couple of socks. Make a couple of socks and subscribe to him. He'd love it. Thank you.
This might sound mean, but just because Jello asked the question about how Frank's Halloween's going, like with his, you know, power situation.
No, that was Billy. That was Billy.
Oh, yeah. It sounds like something Billy would say. I'm willing to bet that Frank's Halloween is going better than Cobes's.
Yeah.
Oh,
Cobes
is doing better. Cobes is doing better. He didn't get evicted. He didn't get evicted. He made a video the next day talking about I'm not evicted. They're just probably not going to, like, you know, renew his lease or nothing.
No, yeah, he's getting kicked out.
Yeah, he's doing better. I texted him the other day. He's doing better.
But, I mean, he made a video today in the fucking cemetery wearing that weird fucking mask and his Ouija board.
Someone in our chat, I'm going to let you guess who it is, Drag, based on this. Asked you this.
Did you? Oh, wait, sorry.
Did you? Wait.
Did you cry my father, Drag? Did you? Look, also, Shanny's at, Christian.
What does Shanny look like?
So it has to be Rigzilla. I didn't even catch most of the questions. I'm just going to ignore it.
What does Shani look like there, Rick?
Like Christian.
Oh, okay, like Christian. Yeah,
she smells like a Wuhan fish market.
She smells like a Wuhan fish market.
Continuing to ignore.
Also, like and subscribe.
Can y'all fucking one of y'all chicks out in the chat please give him some pussy? Please. Just for me. If y'all really love my shit, I don't want lobster bisque. I don't want titty. Just one of y'all, please fuck him.
Are you talking about me?
No.
Yeah, but the end they're just gonna hear.
That's fucked up. And you said what I said was fucked up.
All right, that's all I had to say.
Someone I wonder if it's gonna go like this. Like, yeah. Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh my god. I'm gonna get a job with a drill.
Frank, is there any way that
do what?
I was gonna say, Frank, is there any way you can stick around so we have one of the better members of the geek room here?
Fuck you!
Sure, he only goes for 5 more minutes. We'll fuck it.
I'm fucking Shani. I'm fucking
Shani. That one never gets old.
He was so mad. So depressed. He was so goddamn mad.
Like, look, if it's an either or and it's terrible, that's how it's gonna sound. It's like, it's like, would you rather be skinned alive or fuck Shani?
I'm fucking Shani.
Skinned alive.
Fucking. Drag asked it, and I was like, okay, that's the perfect layup. I'm just holding this button down. And then, like, a minute later, I played it, and he's like, oh, fuck you.
I offered to fuck Rigzilla, and he got weirded out. Like, she pretty much was, like, putting her titties on the glass, and you're just like, ah, no, that's okay. I'd rather watch Chris Chan drink his own semen.
Pass.
Different structure, different
folks.
And
they're right, Black Guy TV. Yeah, never done shit to him. Never done shit to any of these motherfuckers, actually.
You did flag us.
I don't know these motherfuckers. I don't know them from Adam. Never met them before in my life. But yeah, they're going to get on YouTube and do a several-hour-long hangout trashing me.
Somebody we just played the things you
never
said.
Never done anything to them.
It was for your birthday. You didn't like it?
And it has
absolutely nothing to do with them whatsoever.
I invited you tonight.
I don't know these people. Never met them. But yet,
one of them's definitely scary.
YouTube, Twitch, whatever.
Not you.
And do a multiple hour long hangout trashing a man in Kentucky that they do not know and it's never done anything to them. Well, we have a word.
I think Black Eye TV just played the video of him shitting on his mom. And that he would be better if his mom fucking died.
So I'll take the blame for this video. I sent Black Guy TV's video.
Okay. Yeah. I'm assuming he did not like and subscribe.
Mm-mm.
So funny little thing about this video in particular, I think this was the 25th. If you skip ahead 3 more days during the whole G-Man, you know, lies versus pedophilia, which one's worse? Guess what is the same in this video and that video?
His shirt. The shirt and the hat.
He's not wearing the hat, but he's wearing the same shirt.
Damn it. This is why you don't wear the same shirt or shirt at all.
Is this where G-Man gets his shirts from because of the neck being stretched out so much?
I'd like to think that maybe the hat, you know, was this the live stream on Facebook? This is the live stream on Facebook, right?
Yes. Yeah, the first one.
Okay. Because like later on, it comes off. It comes off. That hat is not on, and you can actually see the oil beating up on his hair. Ooh. Like this is, and he's talking about his 20-year-old Asian girlfriend. And I'm like, do you suppose she likes? Do you suppose she's into dudes that don't wash their hair? Like what? I'm just trying
Ron
to
does
be.
Does not look Puerto Rican. Fuck off, Rob.
See, we're all laughing now, but when she fucking moves in with Vaughn and somehow he inherits her diplomatic immunity and he's gonna be, you know, free from like U.S. law, we're fucked.
Man, he's gonna be smashing that shit from the back every night.
I would never turn down a titty.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
At Walmart and I saw a woman wearing a reeling top with a tit flash. She was hot, by the way.
Even Suplex City said he, Rickzilla, but Suplex City said he wouldn't fuck Shani. Like, even Suplex has standards.
Rick read, like, you know, the primer on how to sound like straight guy. I'm just going to let you know.
Oh, I misunderstood you, because when you said that, Rick said that I would never, I was assuming he was referring to you.
No, he's referring to himself.
Oof.
Yeah.
Because I'd say that about you.
Hey, Rick, can you real quick say that vagina feels like a honeycomb?
No. Don't do that to him.
Like, she has cancer.
Why does it have corners?
Is this a duck? This is a duck vagina.
Okay, I don't feel like watching the rest of this because it's not that funny and it's kind of boring. So this is the last video that we
can. Can we put it to the end where he... Wait, can you go to the end where he says, I don't know who Stinky is? Like, just like very... Yeah, give it like...
Does he left of it. Say it?
No.
Yeah, he not, says it.
No, it's not this video.
It's that not this video?
No, this is the one he did last week.
Oh, shit. Never mind. Sorry.
All right, nice try.
So in that particular stream, Vaughn, like I said, he let a lot of shit get out that he probably fucking shouldn't. Like, yeah, he does barricade his fucking door with a fucking desk chair to keep his kids from coming in.
People commented on it a lot.
Apparently, it was his autistic son's idea for Vaughn to spend the SSI money that is allotted to his autistic son on fucking Hot Wheels.
How about you don't let that type of person make those decisions?
Yeah, you let the child make the financial decisions in the home. That makes absolute sense. Vaughn, I know you're watching. That makes absolute sense, Vaughn, to let a child run the finances. Yes, that is exactly why.
No, the autistic child said it was cool.
Or he spent his son's welfare check and blamed it on his autistic kid. I just want to throw it out there. That could be it. Vaughn is that low of a piece of garbage.
It was also Jerry's idea for Vaughn to make a fucking channel talking, you know, dedicated to fucking diecast racing and spend upwards of $30,000 fixing up a barn and buying a shitload of fucking Hot Wheel cars.
Also, who the fuck is diecast racist with Vaughn? Is that you?
That's Vaughn. That's Vaughn.
No, diecast racist.
I don't know.
Oh, diecast racist.
is that you, Wilson? Is it you?
I don't know who that is.
We got to.
I feel like it's you, and you're lying now.
it might be. He may be lying, but let's not forget that Vaughn also claimed that it was the aunt with it. Anyway, that it was her idea that the kids write with their own feces on the wall.
Oh, Marcia.
Marcia, right. It's Marcia's fault that the kids wrote words like stuff like "we're hungry" on their walls and shit down their vents when Vaughn had locked them. That was Marcia's idea. Everything's everybody else's idea. You know what? Doesn't matter whose fucking idea it was. Your kids were locked in their room and you left them without food, you piece of garbage.
I mean, this is just an idea. I might have a kid, but you could properly train the child to knock on the door before they come in, rather than having them just go to saunter in your room at their leisure.
Wait. He doesn't want them knocking on the door. He doesn't want them filming in progress, you little cunts.
Wait.
Oh, no.
You don't want your kids to get to you like zombies in a fucking movie?
So there's a great moment during that stream that Vaughn took down where, yeah, one of his daughters comes in and she's just begging for attention. When she comes in and she starts hugging on him, like trying to, you know, calm daddy down because daddy's yelling at the internet again, in the chat, there's at least 15 people all in caps saying filming in progress. there's a better point during Will Kincaid's stream where Vaughn's daughter comes in and once again she wraps her arms around him trying to, you know, calm daddy down because daddy's yelling at the internet. There is absolutely no reaction from Vaughn.
It's the child's mistake. Oh, sorry, well, go ahead.
Yeah. There's no reaction from Vaughn until Will blows his, you know, screen up to where it's just Vaughn and the daughter, and then Vaughn realizes, oh shit, it's just me. I have to act like a father. So he he does a little peck on the forehead and like gives the most awkward, you know, bring it in, child, hug. It's disturbing.
That's now.
And I hate to say it, but I have to give Will Kincaid credit. That's why Vaughn made that fucking stream, is because even Will told him shit that Vaughn didn't want to hear.
Yeah, because I was talking to Vaughn on Skype, Vaughn admitted that he looks for safe spaces.
Yeah.
Like he wants to go to safe spaces where people won't contradict him. So it's like, well, I already know, yeah, you confirmed what I knew. Thank you. But that just like you lost all sort of credibility that you want to have, man, against people who can't or don't want to hear the truth. And this,
I don't want to be dogpiled on. I want to be part of the dogpile.
Yeah,
I want to yell at people.
Exactly. That's what Vaughn wants. So that's why I just call him. He's just being a little bitch. That's fine. Just be a little bitch, Vaughn.
Wait, so, are you telling me a Cold War veteran is a bitch?
It reminds me of Shani in that way. Wait, Shani, I'm sorry. And Rev, they want to be able to say what they want about whoever they want. They just don't want people to be able to respond.
Yeah, yeah. I'm sorry. I forgot to do this. Cold War veteran. There you go.
That's not how you do it. It's after every single word.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Cold War veteran.
Cold War veteran.
Yeah, Cold War veteran. You know, three word sentence that has like 12 air quotes.
Cold War.
There you go.
Fuck out of here. Complete your contract and talk to me.
Also, G-Man, please Google what these are. That would be solid. Like, just once.
I've already told him that. I told him just stop doing that because you don't get it.
Right, but like people have also told him to stop debating because you're doing it wrong, and like stop rapping because you're doing, like, is there anything that people go, hey Gary, good job, let's do more of that in the future? You think he ever has heard that?
UTIs.
We're crossing the street. Remember he made the video showing me he could do something?
But he ran into a car.
Well, there was one time where he was filming. Like, you don't remember the video? He specifically made a video to show me that he could do something right, and it was crossing the street.
Oh, good for him. It's too bad he didn't
exercise right. I've seen his exercise videos. He does every exercise poorly.
He should have tried grilling some chicken to show you what he can do.
G-Man grilling chicken. He burned off his bottom eyebrow.
Bottom eyebrow. He got that thing.
I was drinking my ass off last night, and I still didn't manage to fucking burn my shit off.
So, like, somebody had brought it up to me, like, when he's trying to make, like, during the whole, like, fucking lion versus pedophilia shit dumpster fire that was, he tries to make the analogy of, you could be the best driver in the world, but you don't know when some fucking retard is up at 3 o'clock in the morning live streaming, screaming into their phone, bebopping across the street, and will walk out in front of you.
Hey G-Man, I'm just gonna let you know this. You can learn the truth. You can't get unraped. Like, it's that simple.
I mean, I have to give G-Man credit. At least no. Vaughn is not a liar.
I don't know what either one of you are talking about. Okay, I am raped drag three times last week.
Like, the whole, like, lion versus pedophilia.
You unraped drag?
Three times in last week.
I'm not supposed to talk about that.
Fucking what? Like, what's this consist of? I'm sorry, Wilson.
I totally shit on you, but I could not hold that one in. That one had to escape.
All right. Yeah, that's all the videos we had for this week, and I definitely don't want to kill myself now. Wilson, you got anything to shout out?
Nah. Sub to Grampy Lobster. Get the old man up there. Let him get some money.
Also, don't give him any money after he gets to 1,000. That'd be really funny. Angry Pumpkin, the Irish bitch. What do you have anything to shout out?
He's drunk.
Pumpkin. Irish whiskey.
Pumpkin, are you there?
Did he pass out? He passed out.
He probably passed out.
He wants to promote Irish whiskey.
He wants to promote Conor McGregor's whiskey in particular. He loves it a lot. He doesn't say anything negative about it on any of the streams he's been on. Conor McGregor whiskey. That's what Angry Pumpkin wants to promote. Yep.
Also, God Save the Queen.
Jell.
Yeah.
Jell, you got anything to promote?
Yeah, I want to promote Vaughn's upcoming leg amputation. That's going to be good. Also, we've already got the song picked out for his death celebration. That's coming soon.
What song is it?
It's called You're Dead.
See, I was picturing something like Yakety Sax, and it would be like a Benny Hill skit, like the pallbearers, like they drop the coffin, Vaughn falls out. We got to, you know, try to pile him back in.
Maybe we could change the lyrics a little bit to like Yakety Yak, don't come back.
Ooh.
You know, I'm just spitballing here.
Drag, you got anything to shout out?
Yeah, Rumor Research Lab is doing live streams now, and she seems pretty cool. So definitely check her out.
She has brilliant guests. I totally recommend checking her out.
She had you as a guest.
Yeah, so I said brilliant guests.
We don't change them adjectives.
That's what your shout out was, by the way, Pumpkin.
Fuck all of you.
But you also shouted out Conor McGregor's whiskey.
Fuck off.
I'm glad you agree with that. And Drag, what were you saying?
Oh, I'm gonna be on the line tomorrow because they asked me to be on. So people are gonna call and ask me stupid questions, and I'm gonna try and be nice.
Oh, G-Man, please call.
See, but yeah, that's gonna be a thing. So you'll get to see me on cam and answer stupid ass questions.
I really hope G-Man calls.
We might play some Phasmophobia tonight.
I want to play the ghost game.
We're going to play the ghost game.
We're
going to be scared. Since Frank's back, I know he's wanting to play, so I'm going to go grab some caffeine, and we're going to play some ghost game here.
We're still playing the ghost game.
Frank, can you do our normal thing?
All of our shit is down below if you want to become a channel member or Patreon. Link's there. We don't have the Amazon link because Amazon's a bitch, and that's pretty much it.
Okay, so this has been the first edition of
Geek Room After Dark. Billy, I didn't order any pizza. You didn't say pepperoni.
Get this dick.
And you remember, as always,
black people do coke.
And
I'm going to go bake some bread with Shanny.
I'm fucking Shanny.